This is a life. Now, you all know from this channel that I love to live frugally and save money. However, one area where I like to live large is on vacation. So I am here in this beautiful room for a belated anniversary slash Christmas getaway to Langdon Hall in Cambridge, Ontario. One look at this place and the prices on their website, and you might think it is only for the rich and famous. And having stayed here a couple times, yes, I can confirm there are definitely wealthy patrons that stay at Langdon Hall. However, us mere mortals, we deserve to be spoiled once in a while too, don't you think? So today I'm going to take you on our vacation here at Langdon Hall. I'm gonna show you all the spectacular nooks and crannies of this place and just how pampered we are going to be. And along the way, I'm gonna share with you some of my tips and tricks to take a luxury vacation for less. Luxury spas and inns are definitely in the realm of affordability for all of us. You just have to be smart about it. Tip number one for luxury vacation on less is to book the cheapest room at an expensive resort. Okay, you guys, look at this room. Would you look at it? It's definitely not a cheap looking room, but it is the least expensive option here at Langdon Hall. And this is one of my best tips because my husband and I actually have stayed here before, and we stayed in one of the pricier rooms. And I can tell you that I like this room just as much. So there's definitely rooms at Langdon that have multi-bedroom suites, or they're in the main house or have sort of different architectural features that make them more expensive. However, every room here at Langdon Hall is going to have the exact same beautiful king-sized feather pillow top beds, the same million thread count sheets. They all are gonna have the beautiful marble floors, the wonderful toiletries and amenities. This room has a Dyson hairdryer, just like the room I stayed at before. And actually, I might like this room better because it has a fireplace. So definitely consider that when you're booking somewhere luxury, is maybe the location on the resort or at the hotel. Choose one that's a little on the cheaper side, and you're still gonna get the same great service, the same great access to beautiful grounds as you would if you were staying in one of the more expensive rooms. Tip number two, book in the off season or on a weekday. So we are staying here on a Monday and a Tuesday, just 3 days before Christmas. But guess what? Because I chose a Monday and a Tuesday, first of all, that already knocked a couple hundred dollars off of our price. And by booking on the couple days leading up to Christmas, but leaving before the Christmas rush starts, we kind of caught that shoulder season where it's not near so pricey. So check out your work schedule. Can you swing a vacation getaway on a weekday instead of a weekend? It's really worth it to try that out. And as far as seasonality goes, we've also stayed here in the summer. If you would like to watch my video review on our summer stay here, check that out. I will link it because this is an incredible spot in the summer season. But if you come here in May or September, you're going to get a better rate than July and August. Tip number three, use a package promotion. Now, a package isn't always cheaper. It totally depends on your situation. So you really need to research it. In our case, we knew we were gonna be eating dinner and breakfast here at Langdon anyway. So a package that included a 3-course dinner for two, as well as a huge country breakfast, along with our room stay, was absolutely way cheaper to book as a package than if we had booked our room separately, gotten our meals separately, etc., etc. However, this might not work out for you if you're not a big eater, if you don't really like breakfast, if you're not planning to have 3 courses for your dinner anyway, maybe a package isn't for you, but if it is, it's certainly a way you can save. I would love to share with you guys right now what we had for our meals at Langdon Hall because they have some of the best cuisine around. Incredible chef. I know they do grow a lot of their own food on the grounds and preserve it themselves, which if you know my channel, you know that really speaks to my heart and my own lifestyle. So I'm gonna give a clip here of everything we had to eat here at Langdon Hall. A little advice. If you're getting a package that includes a 3-course dinner and you can get anything on the menu, definitely get the most expensive thing on the menu. That pricey lobster is the same as the vegetarian risotto, so go with the pricier option to get your money's worth. We loved our trout amuse-bouche for our dinner, and then I got the foie gras, and Andrew got the scallops, which if I were to choose between the two, get the scallops, so delicious. And then I had hen with root vegetables, and the onion puree was to die for. Andrew got venison, which was very hearty and festive for the season. The chocolate balm, if you're a chocolate lover, definitely get that. And the hazelnut pudding was very Christmassy. For breakfast, we had to ask our server because we noticed people were just getting kind of one of each category and the menu didn't specify. We found out we could get as many accompaniments, juices, smoothies as we wanted. So you better believe we did. We got lots of wonderful pastries, smoothies to start, and I highly recommend their butter croissant. So good. A nice pumpkin muffin that was more like a pumpkin cinnamon bun, if you ask me. The salmon was excellent. And of course, here are all our sides and accompaniments. And Andrew ended up getting the smoked cod with béarnaise sauce. So wonderful. For lunch, of all the meals, we actually enjoyed it the most. It was filling, so tasty. So if you're trying out fine dining and you have a choice between lunch and dinner, choose the lunch because you're going to get probably a much better price. They have homemade sourdough bread here every single day as a different variety. I like to get a mocktail. Of course, it's half the price, but also much healthier for me without the alcohol. Andrew got the fish and chips, and I got the truffle mushroom soup. There's a backstory to this. The chef based this soup on a dish he made for William and Kate's royal wedding, and it's honestly the best soup I ever had. Oh, so yummy. We had the bûche de Noël and the Christmas pudding to make our mealtime extra festive. Tip number three is to claim your spa wellness package as part of employee benefits if your company provides that. All right, be honest, who of you loves a good spa treatment or a massage? This girl does, but they can be pretty pricey at a vacation getaway. So the one tip I have is that if you want a spa treatment, look for a hotel that has registered massage therapists. Especially as Canadians, most employee benefit packages will reimburse you for a registered massage. And that is exactly what my husband and I did. We got here a couple hours earlier than our official check-in time to extend our vacation and have some time at the spa. The spa at Langdon Hall is absolutely gorgeous. Okay, we had an incredible couples massage. Shout out to our RMTs, Danae Beauchart and Christian Polaniato. They were incredible. So if you are coming to Langdon Hall for a massage, request one of them. I guarantee you will have an incredible experience. Normally at Langdon Hall, when there is not a pandemic going on, after your massage, you can also enjoy their hot baths, whirlpool, steam room, and sauna. Unfortunately, that wasn't available for us today, but they did transform that area of their spa into a tea room where you could sit and read, have a nice tea and a few complimentary snacks. So thank you, Langdon Hall, for that experience. What a great time we had at the spa. And tip number five is to sign up for email notifications from the luxury destination of your choice. I did this years ago for Langdon Hall because it was always on my bucket list of places to go. And that's exactly how I found out what phenomenal offerings Langdon Hall had at Christmas time and in the winter. It also clued me into the fact that there are certain times of year that they offer promotions and packages to their loyal guests. Just look at some of the incredible decorations and the beautiful grounds at Langdon Hall right now. I can't even describe to you how much it was worth it to book a stay here at this time of year.
What a feeling, now it's time for Christmas. And Christmas is my favorite time of year. It's beginning to look like all my wishes are coming true, that's why I cheer. I've been busy decking the halls, I've been kind to big and small, and now it's time to have a merry holiday. What a feeling when it's time for Christmas. Let's sing a carol and we'll bring it here. I guess that spring and summer, they're all fine, but I've been waiting for the season that's mine. So let it come, yeah, let it come.
Well, cheers to you. If you've made it to the end of this video, thank you for watching along, and I wish you luck and success in your own journey to have kind of the best life you possibly can without having to spend an arm and a leg to do it. My husband and I absolutely adored our stay here at Langdon, and you better believe we will be back. Highly recommend. If you've stayed here before Christmas or it's also on your bucket list, leave me a comment below, or maybe give me a shout out to some of the other luxury destinations you love to stay and some of your tips for staying there for less. Until next time, here are some other videos you might enjoy. See you guys there. For the least, this is Jen.
And Christmas is my favorite time of year.